Hello everyone. So let us start the next segment, that is phrase number 6 of the chapter, the little girl. Okay, now what happens that and she was dragged down to where father was pacing to and fro, hands behind his back. "Well," he said sharply. Mother explained. He stopped and stared at the child. "Did you do that?" "No, no, no, no," she whispered. "Mother, go up to her room and fetch down the damn thing. See that the child puts to bed this instant." So she was dragged down. Dragged down means to take her down forcefully to where father was pacing to and fro. Look at the idiomatic phrase, that is to and fro. To and fro means here and there. Hand behind his back, like typical angry father, okay? Hands behind his back. "Well," he said sharply, mother explained all the things. He stopped and stared at the child. "Did you do that?" Just her father asked her. "Did you do that?" "No, no, no," she whispered. "Mother, go up to her room and fetch down the damn thing. See that the child's put to bed this instant. Just put her down on the bed, okay, and she must be there for the night, right?" So this is the actual room, and she was being scolded for her act, right? Now, crying too much to explain, she lay in the shadowed room watching in the evening light make a sad little pattern on the floor. Then father came into the room with a ruler in his hand. "I am going to beat you for this," he said. "Oh, no, no," she screamed, hiding under bedclothes. He pulled them aside. "Sit up," he ordered, "and hold your hands. You must be taught once and for all not to touch what does not belong to you."
"But it was for your birthday."
Down came the ruler on her little pink palms. So look at the face, try to understand the face. Her father is now very angry on her, okay, and her father went to just scold her and beat her, okay. Now I am going to beat you for this. So she has done a work that he tore up all the pages of his speech, right? So now, "Oh, no, no," she screamed, hiding under. So she was very much feared by his father. Okay, he pulled them as a "sit up," he ordered, and hold out your hands. Her father was going to beat her and to punish her. "Now, you must be taught once and for all to not to touch other but does not belong to you." So this is a teaching also, that we should not touch others' possessions. Okay, so her father was in a mood to teach her a lesson. "But it was for your birthday." The girl was right in her decision. The girl was right in her choice that yes, she was going to make gifts for her father, right? Down came the ruler on her little pink palms. So her father beat her, okay. 8. Hours later, when grandmother had wrapped her in a shawl and rocked her in the rocking chair, the chair clung to her soft body. "What did God make fathers for?" she sobbed. Sobbed means cry noisily. "What did God make fathers for?" भगवान ने पापा को ये पापा को क्यों बनाया है? Why? What did? मतलब किससे बनाया है वो? "Here's a clean hanky, darling. Blow your nose. Go to sleep, pet. You'll forget all about it in the morning." I tried to explain to father, but he was too upset to listen tonight. Her father was very angry and very frustrated, disappointed. So he was in no mood to listen to her mother. Right. So she was told that to have a good sleep and she will forget all the thing in the morning, right? but the child never forgot. Next time she saw him, she quickly put both hands behind her back and red color flew into her cheeks. Now, there is another side of the story, that is the McDonald's. McDonald's means a family of McDonald's, title McDonald's, okay, lived next door. They have five children. Looking through a gap in the fence, in the little girl saw them playing tag in the evening. So the name of the play was tag, right? The father was with the baby Mao on his shoulder. Two little girls hanging to his coat pockets and ran round and round the flower beds, shaking with laughter. Once she saw the boy turn the hose on him and he tried to catch them up, laughing all the time. Look at the picture, you can see clearly that a father is playing with all his children and the children are very happy. Okay, the children are very happy. So this disappointed her more, because her father is not like that father. Uske papa is papa ke jaise nahi hai. Yahi hai unka matlab disappointment ke sabse bada ek reason. ये अगर तुम खुद से समझोगे कि हाँ मेरे पापा नहीं तो मेरे पेरेंट्स अगर उस पेरेंट के जैसे नहीं तो तुम्हें भी ऐसा लगेगा. यू विल फील द सेम थिंग जस्ट लाइक द लिटिल गर्ल. ओके नाउ सो द लिटिल द फादर विद द बेबी माओ. सो द लिटिल बेबी, व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द बेबी? माओ. नाउ देन इट वॉज डिसाइडेड देयर वर डिफरेंट शॉर्ट ऑफ फादर्स. Yes, so different sort of father means there are more kind of father. That one who is very angry, very scary and going to scold her for all the things. And one kind of father that is very much happy, in a jovial mood, joyful mood, right? So she was in a mood, so she can differentiate that kind of fathers. Means the good fathers or bad father, according to her, okay? Suddenly one day mother became ill and she and grandmother went to hospital. So one day her mother became ill and she and grandmother went to hospital for the treatment. Now the little girl was left alone in the house with Alice the cook. So name of the cook is Alice. That was all right in the daytime. But while Alice was putting her to bed, she grew suddenly afraid. Do I have a nightmare? What do you mean by nightmare? Nightmare means a scary dream. Okay, that scared you in the night. Okay, she asks, I often have nightmares and then granny takes me into her bed. I can't stay in the dark. It all gets whispery. Okay, so she was afraid of the darkness and the scary dreams. So she was of the thinking that if a nightmare comes, and what she will do? Because her grandmother always put her on the bed and always with her whenever she saw a nightmare. Okay, so she was quite afraid at that time. That जब वो सोच रहे कि अगर एक nightmare आया, अगर कोई डरावना सपना आया तो मैं क्या करूँगा, मेरा grandma मेरे साथ रहते हैं, जब भी मैं ज़रूरत होता है तो वो मेरे साथ ही रहता है, तो अभी क्या करूं? राइट नाउ यू जस्ट गो टू स्लीप चाइल्ड, सेड एलिस. सो एलिस सजेस्टेड दैट शी शुड स्लीप नाइसली. ओके, पुलिंग ऑफ हर शॉक्स एंड डोंट यू स्क्रीम एंड वेक योर पुअर पा. ओके, चीखना मत, डोंट यू स्क्रीम लाइक. बट द सेम ओल्ड नाइटमेयर केम, मच टू हर सरप्राइज. And she was just thinking of that the nightmare will come, and the nightmare came. The butcher means who always cut meat for trade. Okay, cut meat for trade. A butcher came with a knife and a rope, who came nearer and nearer, smiling that dreadful smile. Dreadful means very fearful, scary smile. Okay, while she could not move, could only stand still, crying out, Grandma, Grandma. She woke shivering to see her father beside her bed, a candle with his hand. So she just saw a nightmare that contains a butcher and a knife and came nearer and nearer to her. And she was shivering. Shivering is trembling. The word means shivering means kaapna. Thand se kaapna nahi to wo, aur ye dar se kaap rahi thi. She was shivering out of a fearness. Now, the father beside her bed, a candle. So when he woke up, she found that, yes, that is my father, who is beside me. What's the matter? He said. Kya hua beta? What's the matter? Oh, a butcher, a knife. I want granny. He blew out the candle, bent down and caught up the child in his arm, carrying her along the passage into the big bedroom. A newspaper was on the bed. She put away the paper, then carefully tucked up the child. Then he lay down beside her, half asleep still with his butcher smile, and all about her he seemed. She crept close to him, snuggled her head under his arm. She held tightly to his shirt. Here is a word called tucked up. Tucked up means covered up nicely in a bed. Okay. Now, and there is another word called snuggled. Snuggled means move into the warm, comfortable position close to another person. So this is called tenderness. Tenderness of being snuggled to ones means the baby girl was snuggled to her father. Okay, and the father was started to tender and care her. So this is a beautiful scene, right? Now, she was afraid first of all, and she wanted granny, but granny and her mother both are absent, and they went for the treatment, but her father was there in the right time when she was very much afraid of the nightmare. Okay, and just he came and he just took care of her child. So this is the actual tenderness of a father, actual care of a father to her child. Now, then the dark did not matter. She lay still. Here, rub your feet against my legs, get them warm, said father. So this is actually some kind of tender words that her father said to her. Like, here, rub your feet against my leg. तुम्हारे पैर मैं मेरे पैर के यहाँ पर घिसो ताकि तुम्हारा पैर गर्म हो जाए क्योंकि वहाँ पर ठंड था. गेट द मोम सेड फादर. नाउ सो दिस इज द एक्चुअल टेंडरनेस ऑफ अ फादर. टायर्ड आउट ही स्लेप्ट बिफोर द लिटिल गर्ल. हिज फादर वॉज वेरी टायर्ड. ओके हिज फादर सॉरी हर फादर वॉज वेरी टायर्ड देन. नाउ अ फनी फीलिंग केम ओवर हर. पुअर फादर नॉट सो बिग आफ्टर ऑल. And with no one to look after him, she was harder than grandmother, but it was a nice hardness. Look, a female figure always some sort of softness is there. A female figure contains softness. A male figure always contains some hardness. It is quite relatable, and you will feel like that. Okay, so whenever she felt the hardness, and the hardness was good. Why? Because her father was with her at the correct time, at the time when she needs her father beside her. Right? It was a nice hardness. Hardness was nice. She always felt that the softness of her mother and her grandmother, but it was her father who just tendered her up. Correct. And every day he had to work and was too tired to be a MacDonald. She had torn up all his beautiful writing. She stood up suddenly and sighed. What's the matter? Asked her father. Another dream. Uske papa ne pucha, koi alag sa sapna dekh liye kya? Oh, said the little girl. My head's on your heart. I can hear it going. What a big heart you have got, father dear. So, his child means the girl, started loving her father. Okay, and the girl actually thinks that, yes, this is the thing, this is father, and this is father's care, this is father's tenderness. Yes, and I like to hear the sound of my father's heart. So this is the beautiful story. Okay, beautiful story in the sense that a girl who is always neglected, avoided, but she was not actually been neglected or avoided. Okay, but a father who loves her, who loves his child very much, now comes to her and just giving all his tenderness, his care, his love for the child, and the child just started loving her father. So this is the actual thing. Now, so this is for today's lesson. Thank you.